Welcome back to Bending 10. It's time for flexibility, so cross your right leg over your left, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and then we're gonna dive down into our hamstrings. So let's go. Trying to touch the floor is the aim of the game today. Holding for 10 seconds, you're locking that left leg in place. We don't normally lock the legs, but we do in this scenario. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth, crossing over to the right-hand side this time. And we're just constantly exhaling out as we stretch, enjoying the stretch. Breathing in and then trying to place both palms on the floor. With the exhale, let's go. Rolling all the way back up, crossing the left over the right, and again, diving down. Over to the right hand side. If you can't touch the ground at the moment, don't worry, and work towards it each day. Build it up a little bit more. Over to the left. And both palms on the floor. Up we go. Next stretch, find your nearest sofa or wall and spread your legs like this. If you don't have a sofa or wall, just spread them on the ground like this, that's fine. You're going to imagine you're in James Bond, you're James Bond in Goldfinger, and he's got the laser coming down to cut him open. So you've got to stay there because you're tied down. You're being tortured. It's a stretch of torture, but good torture. If you're in pain, stop. And you're just going to breathe through this stretch. Got about 20 seconds left of this now. Keep going and really open yourself up. Perfect. Once you finish the gold finger stretch, it's time to come into the frog. So put your feet together and have your arms just resting on the outside and just push down gently on the exhale. Just starting, keeping these shoulders in line, and then we're going to progress this stretch. Pushing down a little harder, starting to feel the groin engage. Really be the frog. That's the answer. And then we're just going to grade it up again, taking the ankles and bending over like so. Trying to get your head to your feet. Lovely. Swiveling round. Time to go back to hamstrings. So, first of all, just practice sitting up in this position and sitting straight in this position, because actually that's not a given, that's not easy to hold that for a long period of time. And then we're going to look at touching the toes for 30 seconds, breathing out. If that's easy enough for you, you can go behind the feet. And again, 30 seconds of this. Imagine that someone's got a weight on your back, or they've put their weight on your back and they're kind of pulling you in. So each time, each breath, each exhale, you're going to actually try and stretch more. So you could have a real bend in the arms here, depending on how flexible you are. Halfway. Let's do another 15 seconds of this.
and swivel around.
Onto all fours. We're going to do some cat-cow.
As we inhale, rounding the back, dropping the head and neck.
And on the exhale, the cow, extending and lengthening.
Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth.
And you can make the cat-cow noises if you really want to. I'm going to refrain from doing that.
And you can also
imagine your spine, just like imagine you're doing an x-ray, so you can see it bending and turning. Although you might not want to think like that, so maybe you don't. Depends how many x-rays you've had, I suppose. And take this further and roll like a wave. I do like a wave into child's pose. And from here, I'm just gonna shuffle back a little. We're gonna be a snake. It's time to be a snake. We're gonna do the cobra. And we're gonna stalk. We're gonna imagine we've got some prey. We're gonna just stalk above the ground on the inhale. Stalking the prey. Now we're gonna imagine we've caught it, ate it, and we're gonna do some sunbathing. So on the exhale, really slowly extending and stretching the back. And you're the sunbathing snake. You need to get a good tan on your scales. Enjoy that moment before curling back into child's pose again. We'll do this two more times, so. In through the nose, out through the mouth, remember. And then
rotating back into a wave formation to do it once more. You can do it as fast or slow as you wish.
Also remember with flexibility that you're going to be more flexible in the afternoon. Perfect. You're going to be more flexible in the afternoon.
Because your muscles have had the day to adjust. Whereas in the morning, which is where I'm at now, by the way, if you get out of bed, you're pretty stiff and your muscles just aren't as flexible. So if you're really good one day and really bad the next day, remember, when have you trained? Have you trained in the morning or the afternoon? Because the results are going to be very different. So you can only compare afternoon and afternoon or morning and morning. Because it really makes a difference. The next exercise, you're going to clamp your left foot down, your left knee, and point it. You're going to point that right foot and knee as well. And on the exhale, you're going to gradually extend that right knee to try and straighten it, but you can't because you're clamping it in place with the right arm. And that's on purpose, of course, because it gives a true indicator of your progress. So now, let's clamp out, lock out that right knee, point the toe on the left, and extend. But the left elbow is going to prevent us from going further. And the great thing is about this, again, is it catches your progress, because you're catching it. So this time we're going to flex the foot. We're doing exactly the same thing, but flexing the foot. Your other leg, that left leg in this case, is counterbalancing. So it's really important that stays on the ground. And I'm going to try again, the same thing. This time the right leg doing the counterbalancing. Let's counterbalance away and extend that left. And when you flex the foot again, that's is going to be less. You can just roll over to your front here. I'm actually going to swivel around so you can see me properly do the next one. Going to grab the ankles. And as we exhale, we're going to rise up with the ankles, the knees, and extending the chest and lifting it off. On the inhale, we're going to come back down. We'll do this for 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, and down. And lift off again. Imagine you're skydiving, maybe over New Zealand or somewhere really beautiful, somewhere that's out of reach at the moment, but not out of your imagination. And let's have another one. This is a much better thigh stretch than the one you just do when you're standing up and you just put one leg and kind of hold it. This gets into it much more deeply. This is the stretch that footballers should be doing before they warm up. Perfect. To finish with then, we're gonna get on our toes, hands out in front, we're gonna keep them kind of fingers facing in. I'm gonna do little bounces, 1, 2, 3, 4, and extend with those legs straight. Yeah? So this is your marker again, keeping it on the floor, trying to extend those legs. Whilst keeping those hands on the floor if you can. If you can't, don't worry, let them drag up a bit. And one more, and this time we're going to roll up with this. Thank you very much for joining me today. And please subscribe to the YouTube channel, that would be fantastic. The song of the day today is Thinking of You by Sister Sledge, because this exercise and this routine really does put your best interests at heart, so I am thinking of you all. And please spread the gospel, spread the word of what we're doing here, and I'll see you very soon for another video. Thank you.